Hey, guys, this biggest house is becoming something else. So, like the gist this particular night. So today is actually Saturday night, and the housemates they actually went for party, and they partied themselves to stupor. The ladies especially actually partied themselves to stupor, and coming back there's been one drama or the other. But before we go into the drama, hello, my name is Vicky. If you're seeing my face for the very first time, thank you so very much for clicking on my videos to watch, and please consider to hit on the red subscribe button, subscribing to the channel, and do not forget to turn on your notification bell so that you'll be informed whenever I post a new video. All right, so guys, actually the housemates were giving clothes, like I said in my earlier videos, and they went for a party. They partied, and guess what, guys? Erica was super drunk. Like, throughout the party, you will just know that Erica don't go. Like, she has gone straight up. She's no more in this particular world again. Erica is somewhere else, because she was just struggling to, like, kiss Lekon, like, all over Lekon. And I was like, oh, what is going on here? Let me watch this today. My eye was just shining and just waiting to see the particular moment it will happen, you understand? And she was just all over Lekon. Though Lekon came out, when after the party, they came out and they actually were talking about, Lekon was saying that in the party she was actually telling him that please, she doesn't want to have sex on national TV, that she should make sure she doesn't, you understand, that we should keep Kidwire away from her, that if he sees Kidwire looks so delicious that she wants to eat Kidwire. And guys, when they came out, Lekon wanted to run mad. Like, Lekon literally wanted to run mad, because Lekon was bent on protecting Erica at all costs from Kidwire, because she's feeling like Kidwire is drunk and Erica is drunk, and then he does not want Kidwire to sleep with Erica. And they were having a conversation with Praise, and Praise was just telling him that he should chill, it's not going to happen. He's like, no way, as in Lekon was mad. And at some point I'm just feeling like Lekon is not obsessed with Erica. Like, the way he's going about it, he legitly went to lie down beside the bed that Erica and Kidwire normally lay down, you understand, the next bed to the bed. And then guess what happened? Kidwire came to the bed and was kissing and was kissing Erica. You need to see how the camera actually, in fact, let me just give you guys that clip.
So far. Because I don't go, we know so far beating an outbreak. Kid go to beat you. Oh, Benny.
Did you see how the camera actually zoomed in on Lekon, and Lekon was running like raving, like seriously, Lekon lost it completely. In fact, as I'm even making this video right now, Lekon is actually laying outside because he said his head wants to go gaga because Erica is gone. Like, Erica is so drunk. And the funny part is that Lekon is actually complaining that Kidwire is actually supposed to be with her, but he's not taking care of her. Like, he's not showing concern. And then I'm just wondering, and I'm thinking that, yeah, there's some sense in it, because at this very point in time, Kidwire is okay, as in Kidwire is not so drunk yet. He's still feeling himself, he knows himself very well, but that concern, that care is not there. It is Dorothy and Tolani Badge that has been taking care of Erica. Kidwire has just been sitting in the lounge on the dining section, and he has just been lounging there while Lekon was just there busy hoping and praying that Kidwire doesn't come into the room. That's before he actually came to do what he did there, you get. And that's just how it is, you get. I just feel like Kidwire actually, I don't know if that is how he is, or he's just playing games with Erica, you get. I don't understand, but this is something that Erica actually knows properly before she got herself into the whole drama, you get. But Lekon is just more or less like beginning to act very desperate, beginning to act like he's obsessed, like he's beginning to act in a way, like, because I for one, I also blame Erica, because if Erica just comes out straight to actually tell this guy, I'm not fit to leave all this mental, physical explanation that you're giving, just go straight to the point, I cannot date you, so that this guy might just get a hold of himself and maybe move on. Because with this, all this mental attraction, this attraction, that attraction, is really giving the guy hope that someday they might actually become a thing. And the fact that in the dancing hall, or in the party hall rather, they were busy, she was busy trying to kiss or just rubbing, falling all over him, and all those things. I feel like it's a green light because of how he honestly really feel for her, you get. So that's just what has actually been going on. And then coming back from the party to Tolani badge, oh god, Tolani's badge, our own drama, is out of this world. I just feel like Prince is in for Oputa panel every day, because at this point Tolani badge is always marking her territory, and she does not want to see any, she doesn't want to see especially Watoni close to Prince. Okay, what happened was Prince and Watoni, Prince has been dancing with the whole ladies in the party, and then when Prince and Watoni, they started dancing, you need to see the fire in Tolani Badge's eyes, you guys. And then when they came back from the party, Prince was just talking to Trikiti about it, and he does not understand why Tolani Badge will not allow him be friends with people he used to be friends with. Like, he has made it clear to her that okay, we are the one, we are an item now, so let me be friends with who I was. Tolani Badge now walked up and was like, who are you talking about? And then he was like, we are talking about you. Trikiti was like, yes, we were gossiping about you. And then she was like, so what are you guys saying? He was now explaining to her. They were just going back and forth, back and forth. I just feel like more or less like that Tolani Badge's relationship with Prince, it's like a toxic relationship. I don't know, because at the point I don't see that connection, I don't see that affection in Prince's eye towards Tolani Badge. It's just like, okay, this is what I'm stuck with. Because Trikiti was telling Tolani Badge that the person that you should even be worried about in the whole of this party or the whole of this snatch thing that you're thinking that Watoni wants to snatch your boyfriend is Nengi. Because that's if she actually knows. I think she trusts Nengi so much where Prince is compared to Watoni. Not knowing that Prince really has a thing for Nengi. And Prince has even asked Nengi out, telling Nengi, I really like you, I like you, I like you. Prince, Nengi is the one that Prince really like. And then Trikiti just gave her a hint that the person she should be, he told her in front of Prince that the person she should be scared of is Nengi. And I feel that's also the case. And the truth of the matter is that I never even started this thing, never even reached how many days now. You're just policing him, you're just what she's saying, that you should mark boundaries. Mark which boundaries, madam? In a house, like Trikiti would say, in a two-bedroom flat, that's like a two-bedroom. There's no how you want to think that because you guys are having a thing, you shouldn't have conversation with other ladies, or you shouldn't talk to other female housemates. It's not going to happen. But at this point, I just feel that relationship is going to be really, really toxic, because like Tolani Batch doesn't want to see any lady around her man. I just feel that is more or less like insecurity in the highest order. That's my own opinion, because of the way she's actually going about it. I just feel she's insecure, you know, because she actually knew that she is Prince's second choice. And then why do you stress yourself in things like that? You know that you're somebody's second choice. Omo, you have to chill now and just look for somebody that you would definitely be the person's first choice, instead of stressing yourself, always worried about the person letting you go, always worried about the person cheating on you, always, because in a relationship where there's no trust, I don't see how it's going to work. Like, Prince has been looking mentally and emotionally drained. Like, the guy is tired, because he has been explaining that he doesn't want to be in this kind of situation where he would just be the one, where he cannot be talking to people he used to be cool with, or he leaves the house and then he's not cool with certain people that they lived in the same house with, because he was complaining about also not talking to him and Nengi giving him attitude that he doesn't even understand what is actually going on. Either he feels that it is not right and he doesn't want to be caught in such triangle, he doesn't want to be caught in such situation. And I really, really do understand how he actually feel. But at this point, the rate at which they are going in this house, Tolani Badge has been telling Prince, like, they've been having that conversation up to the point that they've gone to bed now, and it's the same thing that they have been arguing. But for me, I will always say that I really do not feel like Tolani Badge had, as in like Prince really has affection for Tolani Badge. That's just the truth. He's just maybe using her to actually pass time. And at this point, in fact, Prince should even, if it's possible, he should jackpot, because the way Tolani Badge is going, he will not be able to handle her. Tolani Badge is not that girl, you get. So that's just it. Prince was talking to Lucy. They were talking about the whole Nengi and Lekon issue, talking about how Lekon has just been stubborn about the whole thing. He has spoken to Lekon about it, that he should let it go, that he should, as in, like, you guys need to, you should see how Lekon has been pacing around. Lekon went outside, sat down, and was just thinking about his life for for like minutes before he just fell asleep, and he has been lying there like somebody that is homeless. I just feel me for one, I feel with pity for him. You know why? Because this whole thing that has been going on doesn't really, like, Kid Wire doesn't flinch. He doesn't even feel as if anything is happening. He doesn't, like, he's in competition with somebody that does not even care, like with somebody that's not even seeing him. Or I feel maybe it's because of the confidence that Kid Wire actually has, that Erica actually likes him over the Lakon, you understand? So that's just how it has been. Erica is intoxicated, V is messed up. Like, V is messed up, has been yelling, and I don't know if she wants to throw up or what, but they've been able, Dorothy and Tolani Bash, they've been able to put her to sleep. She has slept, even Erica has slept, but Lakon just made sure that Kid Wire doesn't sleep with Erica, though he has slept up outside and Kid Wire has actually gone to bed to sleep. And finally, let me just talk about, guys, I really don't understand Watoni's move with Erica. I don't know, it's gonna end in tears tomorrow, if maybe much later today when Eric leaves the house, because Watoni has just been, in fact, everything in Watoni's head is booed up. Like, I don't know if she doesn't have any other content than being booed up with somebody, because I've just been seeing her lately. I've been seeing her moves with Eric, and I'm like, what's trying to go on there? Are you guys trying to become an item? And right now they are even on the same bed sleeping. You get, I don't understand Watoni. My eyes are really on her. I'm going to bring you guys the gist if at all anything happens between, if Eric doesn't leave today, I'm going to bring you guys the gist, because at this point, me, I'm tired. I don't even understand Watoni anymore. You get the whole body language, the whole too much hugging, dancing in the party hall, and they are, you know, the way they've been, you know, their drama. I'm here to just sit. So housemates, they've just been able to just, they had some fun, they came back, they made indomie, they ate it in the pot, they made indomie twice, and they all ate it from the pot, like, as piping hot as it is. They dropped it on the table and they all dived into it, they ate it. They've been catching some fun, and right now the most housemates are asleep, and that's just it. And it was an interesting night. I hope to bring you guys more gist, more updates on what has been going on in the house, because we are always watching. Like, I hope you enjoyed this one. Give this video a thumbs up, leave me a comment down below, and please, if you have not subscribed, do well to hit on the subscribe button, subscribe to the channel, and do not forget to turn on your notification bell so that you'll be informed whenever I post any video. And I'll see you guys in my next one.